Hello, we are again diving a bit deeper into the world of Ladybug. This time we will create this beauty here, a radiation analysis this space here. Maybe better show in 3D, so it's a more advanced version as we had last time. So we will create a radiation study for the ground level of this kind of city public space. But not just that, we will also look into some alternative parameters for the output colors. So this is the classical Ecotect color scheme, but there are more, so I just wrote this down. So we can select color schemes from all these here, just to give you an impression. For example, we could sunlight hours has its own color scheme radiation benefit. So we could, for example, put in 23. Yeah, that would look like this. And the output is in kilowatt hours per square meter. And well, for the legend, there's more. You can actually change the font, the font size, the legend scale, and low bound, high bound. You could basically control the output range. That's makes sense if you want to compare several studies next to each other, because then they all have the same range, let's say from 0 to 160 or 200. Then I will also show a way to display the kilowatt per hours with a tag on the actual surface. So for example, like this. So you can actually then see exactly on which area which amount of kilowatt per hours. Yeah, so this study is very useful if you, for example, want to install PV panels on your roof and you want to make sure that these are effective, or like roughly calculate on how much energy you could collect. Yeah, at the moment this is all a bit looks all a bit messy. It's because the original geometry is a bit complex with all these curves that creates a mesh which is not very regular. But if you have a specific area, you could also replace the original surface with a temporary kind of just a squared surface. Then it will divide the surface in a grid, and then you have a very neat output. Therefore, also the all the numbers and text is aligned. One thing to say, I added this kilowatt per hours with a small Python script. So I basically extracted the numbers and combined it with a text. It's just playing around. So I will show all this now. Let's start fresh. The sunlight radiation study component can be found here. It's actually the first one in the environmental analysis box over here. And it's different to the sun hour study. The sun hour study measures the time of direct sunlight, and it doesn't take in consideration any weather data, only the location. The radiation study, however, actually builds a sky dome based on the weather data. So it's a much more accurate way of actually measuring the sunlight. But it doesn't tell you the hours, it tells you the energy. But it can also give you an idea about possible plant growth, or as it's also explained here, this component is also good for surfaces representing outdoor spaces such as parks or seating areas where radiation could affect thermal comfort or vegetation growth. One more thing, it does not calculate any reflection of materials. So for that, you might then need to consider honeybee. Honeybee can do these things. But nevertheless, this is, for me, it's perfectly useful, especially for outdoor spaces. Don't try to use it for indoor it won't give you a very accurate result. Okay, we build it again like the last script. Look at the component and look what we need to input. Okay, north, again, we don't need, it's given, the model is already orientated to the correct north. We need the geometry, which is in that case my street level. B-wrap, we need a B-wrap. I will select these and hide them. So we also need the context, which are my buildings. And because the buildings are, it's a mesh. So that means I need to first input a mesh. Yeah, that's my mesh. And I can actually directly plug it in here. The grid size determines the resolution of the analysis, and because this model is in meter, I would choose 10 meter as a maximum, and then we can go over smaller. But I would recommend to always start with a higher number. Distance from base, you can either put the panel. So that is possible. You can add a slider, or you can also input the data here with right click and set data item. The distance from base basically determines on which side of the geometry the test is done. So it's just to ensure that it's on the correct side. But then we need the selected sky matrix. So that is, now it gets again interesting. Okay, my selected sky matrix, that you can find here. It's, I hope I pronounced it correctly, Generative Cumulative Sky Matrix. So it's like an additive, it builds an additive model out of the weather data. I will just show in a minute how that looks like. We need the weather file, the weather E plus weather data file, and as again, we always need the ladybug tool, otherwise nothing works. So this one, the download file. So we, this time, normally I just always put the toggle here, but there's another one, it's called force start toggle from, it's a special toggle from Ladybug, and it does the same thing what the normal toggle does, but it always turns back to false when you restart your script. So when you save the script and you restart, it always goes back to false, which is great, because most of the time you're gonna forget to turn it off. So let's put that here. I'm gonna turn it off, on, and get the weather data. Click link to clipboard, that's what I do. And input this here. I showed these things already before, so you can skip this if you don't need it anymore. Plug this in here. So this component calculates your sky matrix. You have some options here. You can use either 1 or 0. And if you use 1, then it becomes a very detailed mesh, which then gives a much more accurate output. But for what we use it for, it's fine with the normal output, because it also takes quite long, much longer than if we would use the more precise method. Then we need, so I'm gonna show you how that looks like. We need two more components. One is Ladybug select the sky matrix. This is to determine which day of the year or which analysis period we gonna check. So we can put that in here and can connect this in here. If we now check Cumulative sky metrics failed to collect data. So that's because it's turned off. We still need to run it. So we can do that. We use the same toggle as here. Just copy and paste and run. I don't know why, it's probably because it ran it before, but normally you would get a black, like a command line window where it tells you that it's calculating the sky, indirect and direct, or diffuse and direct. But I guess because I already ran this, the same weather data, it already stored that on my computer. So yeah, anyway. You should now be able to, it doesn't say anything here, but I guess it worked. And yeah, just to show you what a sky matrix looks like, you could go here into Ladybug and click the sky dome and input this here. And it will create three domes. One is the diffuse radiation, sky radiation, basically all the light coming from the sky, so all the sunlight which is reflected in the atmosphere, and then the direct radiation, the light coming from directly from the sun, and then another one where this is combined. That's why you have an option here to actually remove the diffuse light or remove the direct light for the calculation. And if we would use the sky density with 1, then this would create a much more denser division. Okay, I hope it's more clear. And basically this sky dome will be projected onto your test surface. Okay, let's turn that off, don't need that now. And we can actually, we don't need anything more for now, we can actually run it. Yes, hello. So yeah, you see it calculated the whole year. So it's from the 1st of January to the 31st of December. And yeah, it gives you the output. Let's hide this here. Kilowatt hours per square meter. So what we could do is to, so this is kind of an average output, or let's say the data is actually more diverse than this. So let's try to display the text onto the mesh. So we have the mesh. This is our mesh. This is the context mesh. These are the test points, and we have the radiation result here. So what we can do, we can take our text tag and the location. So this is, would be the location of the test tag, would be on these points, on the test points, and the result would be this. So then you would display your output onto each of these surfaces. If you want to get rid of all the commas, you can then also say integer, result integers, and it just gives you a round number. Not a round number, but an integer rather than a float point. So if you want to show actually the unit and at the end, I just show you very quickly how you do a Python script, a very simple Python script. Use the radiation result, put it into X, open the script, and then we create a very simple for loop. For I in X is I, call it text, I text. Now all the Python guys will kill me, obviously, but it's fine. And then is string I plus, I guess. A bit kilowatt hours, and print text should work. Yeah, of course, I forgot something. You need to make sure that this is understood as a list. So now it works. So x can be a variable, but it can be also a list of items. So, and here you need to choose, you can choose what the input actually is. So now it should work. Yeah. So basically, what I'm doing here is I say for every item in the list X, I call every item I text is the string. So I create the string from the number and add the kilowatt per hours and then print it. For sure, it is a more elegant way, and I can already hear all the comments, but it does what I want. So now I can take this and actually wanted to, yeah, no, we need to do this. So it's, we have an integer and then output into here. And then we'll just add me the kilowatt per hours at the end of the number, which I think is a valid thing to do.